Hi friends, today we are going to solve day of the programmer problem from the implementation of the algorithm. Maria invented a time machine and wants to test if the time traveling visit to Russia on the day of programmer, the 256th date of the year, is in the inclusive range of 1700 to 2700. From 1700 to 1917, Russia's official calendar was Julian calendar. Since 1990, they used Georgian calendar system. The transition from Julian to Georgian calendar system occurred in 1918, when the next day of the January 31st was February 14th. This means that is 1918, February 14th was the 32nd day of the year in Russia. When you read it, it would be feeling as it's a very complicated problem. But in reality, it's not. It's just basically to check if it's a leap year. It's kind of a leap year kind of problem. So in both calendar system, February is the only month with a variable amount of days. It has 29 days during a leap year and 28 days during all other years. In Julian calendar, leap years are divisible by 4. In Georgian calendar, leap year are either of the following: divisible by 400, divisible by 4, and not by 1000. So these are the two important things to check. Okay, so any year before 1918 is going to be a leap year. So here are the few examples. For example, in year 1982, 1984 is divisible by 4, so it's a leap year. Okay, and 1918, September 12th, so the answer is of the leap year after now, 1918, so the answer is 12/09/1984. Okay. So let's check, let's do for the leap year, means in the, Georgian calendar, for the Georgian calendar system. Let's do it for the Julian calendar system. You can go and check the difference between those two. So any year before 1918, if the year is divisible by 4, it automatically means it's going to be a leap year. Return if it's not a leap year, then the value would be 13. We could check those, I think, from various examples given. It is pretty clear. So, STR, year. And the same way you're going to do for the Georgian calendar. But in Georgian calendar system, the number should be divisible by 400. And if it's divisible by 4, it should not be divisible by 100. So those are the two conditions you need to check. So if year is greater than 1918, you have to check if the year is basically divisible by 400. Equal to 0, or it should not be equal to zero. So this is the condition. Would be returning. Or just copy it. Or let's just write it just for the reference point. 09 dot plus str And if the year is 1918, then the value would automatically become 1918. Let's run the code. As you could see, it passed all the public test cases successfully. Let's submit the code and see the results. Most probably it would run. As you're able to see, it in this case also all the test cases successfully passed. One thing that I have implemented in this code, which is kind of a trick, is basically I knew what would be the value if the year is leap or if it's not. Another way could be just calculating the 256th day that is coming, which would also be a bit complex, but you could always do that. And apart from that, I guess everything is pretty similar. Just for, there are two types of calendar, Julian and Georgian. So for the Georgian, this is the functionality. It should be divisible by 100, or if it's divisible by 4, it should not be divisible by 100. And for the Julian, if it's divisible by 4, it's a leap year. So these are the two differences. And if it's in 1918, then the value is 2609-1918. You could just go and manually check it. This is the basic idea. Or at a time when I was trying to solve it, it might feel a bit overwhelming, but trust me, it's a pretty easy problem. And as always, I always keep you reminding you, if you have a better way of solving the same problem, do send me in the comments so that I could check and review those. And as always, thanks for watching this video and stay tuned.